This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use the payback method to evaluate long-term investment proposals. What is the payback method? Let's start with that. It evaluates, there's some characteristics here, it evaluates how long it takes to pay back or recover the initial investment for whatever the long-term investment might be. So for example, we'll use an example in another slide here that if we want to purchase a machine, let's say a copy machine, how long will it take for us as a business to recover the initial investment to purchase that machine? So the second bullet point here describes the payback method. It's the time it takes to generate enough cash, receipts, net of any cash outflows, to recover the initial investment. And it's typically stated in years. The two other important characteristics, the payback method ignores the time value of money and ignores any cash flows after the payback period. We simply want to know how many years will it take for us to get our initial investment back. Here's an example of a long-term investment proposal that we're considering, and we'll talk about how to use the payback period method to determine how long it's going to take for us to get back our initial investment. What you see here for this example coincides with the examples that I used in separate lectures for finding how to find the net present value and how to use the net present value to evaluate whether to take on a long-term investment or not. It also coincides with another video that relates to how to use the internal rate of return to determine if we should make an investment in this long-term asset. So this information ties back to both of those. If you want to take a look at those methods as well, you'll see a similar example. So we are, in this example, Jackson's Quality Copies. We make copies for customers and provide other services as well. And we expect to pay $50,000 for a new copier. This is what we're evaluating. We're trying to figure out if we want to do this or not. The copier is expected to last 7 years, and the annual maintenance costs will be about $1,000 a year. And the labor cost savings will be about $11,000 a year. So the net of these two cash flows is we are going to see about $10,000 come in every year related to this investment. And then we're going to sell the copier at the end of 7 years for $5,000. Here's a chart that will help us to determine how long it's going to take to recover that initial $50,000 investment when we purchase this copy machine. What you see here is that at the very beginning, we're going to spend $50,000. And so at the very beginning, year zero means today. Today, we have an unrecovered investment balance of $50,000. And you can look at the footnotes here to clarify if you like. And then each year, as I calculated on the previous slide, we're going to see a net cash inflow of $10,000. Right on down the line each year. And what that does then is it reduces our unrecovered investment balance. We start with $50,000 and then we subtract $10,000 and now we have an unrecovered balance of $40,000. And then the next year we have another positive cash flow of $10,000 which reduces our unrecovered balance to $30,000. So we're trying to figure out how long it's going to take for us to get to recover that initial investment to get our $50,000 back. And the answer is it'll take 5 full years. In that fifth year, once we have our cash inflow of $10,000, we have fully recovered the initial investment of $50,000. So the payback period in this example is 5 years. And how does that help us then to determine if we want to take on this investment? Well, oftentimes companies will establish a set number of years, and if we can't recover our initial investment over those, whatever the number of years are for that company, then we're not going to take it on. So for example, with this company, let's say that if we can recover our initial investment within, let's say, 4 years, we don't take this investment on because it's going to take us 5 years. If the company's established a policy that says, well, if we can recover our initial investment within 6 years, we'll take it on, assuming that the net present value and internal rate of return also provide positive results, then for this example, we'd say, yes, let's do it because we're going to get our initial investment back within 5 years. And if 6 years is the requirement, we're in good shape. So this is the payback method. And again, it simply tells us how many years it will take for us to recover our initial investment.